Hello World. Today we are playing Drakensang, The River of Time. The prequel to the game Drakensang. I think you question what is Drakensang? Drakensang is a role-playing game. A role-playing action game, to be more precise. And it plays in Aventurien, which is part of the roleplay universe of the Dark Eye, which is comparable like D&D. Can compare D&D in the standing of it in the English market to the Dark Eye, it's in German Das Schwarze Auge, in Germany. I will tell you a little bit about later on how the game mechanics function in the character design phase, but first we get into the intro, and later on in part 2, where we see actual gameplay, I will tell a little bit more about the world, how it's built and what different races, cultures and so on are in this game. So let us start a new game. We play on difficult because hard is not hard enough.
Come down.
Well, Forgrim, let's get you a pale ale.
Alas, the beer tastes only half as good without Ardo. Those were the days back then.
None of you has ever told me what actually happened back then.
Because it's a secret.
Yes, that's what you keep telling me over and over.
Maybe you're old enough for it now. Listen. It's a story about betrayal and greed. And the beginning of a friendship. Previously unknown adventurer was also with us. Otherwise, we would probably not have pulled it off. Somehow, this person got entangled in our problems during the autumn of the year 1009, after Busparan's fall. We all met on the journey, as it so often happens. How might it have been for the Greenhorn? Just imagine, Clarice. I'll reveal to you who it was.
Yeah, and we are back. So, I guess there are some questions. So, Ferdok is, like you have seen, a medieval city. So, the game plays in a medieval setting with fantasy elements like magic and gods, and But it's not as high as D&D, but it's much lower on a lower power scale. So that normal characters are decently balanced, I would say. So yeah, Bosporan's fall. It's Bosporan was practically something like the Roman Empire. It's the Western Roman Empire in this world. So it fall, and after this, the new Reich, the Middle Realm, established his foothold, so to say. We will play a Meta Mage background as initiated in the higher arts of magic. The Meta Mage can send skeletons to fight his opponent and perform other powerful magic. So, in the end, we are a very diverse mage, which can practically learn every spell and cast, yeah, everything. Skeletons could be a problem in some cases in game if it's built in. If you play a roleplay game, so roleplay tabletop game, it would be a problem for most people that you're running around with a skeleton, or you summon skeletons. That's not very after the belief system of most of the people in the Middle Realm, at least. So then we go back to the culture. The Novadi comes from a proud as a tribe and is not familiar with the customs of the Middle Realm. Okay, what's a Novadi? Practically, it's like you could say the Arabic Peninsula in 650 AC, so around Mohammed's Crusades and Jihads against the Byzantine Empire, with horses and women have very poor rights and so on, which is okay for them. So they are a desert people practically, and many of them are merchant warriors. And if you are a merchant or warrior, you can be somebody who plunders and so on too. So the race to the meet is something like Middle East. So that's practically the setting our characters out, if you want to compare them out of the real world. The Arabic Peninsula, like I told you. I will go into the expert mode. We play a male character. And the expert mode says, I have cancel it, because we have to first roll a name. Habilet bin Aslam. Okay. Sheena. Asaf ibn Ali. Yeah, that's, yes, Asaf. Yes, that sounds decent. So, how is this game works out? You have leveling points, which you put into, you see the green numbers. This is practically the cost for if you want go from point 0 to 1 by sneak, you pay 3 points. Then from 1 to 2 is 7, and so on. And it's different for other talents, like combat talents are more expensive, and spells can be more expensive or cheaper. Depends on the individual spell in this case. The attributes are the basic part of the game, so that's the baseline, like in D&D. But in D&D, you mostly don't roll on the attributes, but here you roll on your based attributes, d20, So, or you can use the attributes to roll on it, so to say. So that's the most important part. We have courage, cleverness, intuition, charisma, dexterity, agility, constitution, and strength. So we play a mage. We have some spells. Skeletarius, that summoning skeleton is very important. Right click on it and we open the lock. Okay, awakens the skeleton whose power varies according to the modifier. So the better we know the skills, the higher, the better with the skeleton. Maybe it's not a normal skeleton, but it's a skeleton warrior, skeleton knight, skeleton mage, or something like that later on. Cost 8 astral points, I will come to it later on. Yes, he's active 60 seconds, so that's okay. Not long for this. And you see we roll it on... You every time roll 3 dice, and here you need courage and charisma. It's not... Behind the Skeletarius, courage, charisma. So to say, we rolled 3d20. And if you are, if the eye of the dice is the same has the same number as the attribute, or is lower, then it's, yes, you have succeeded. And if it's higher, then you have to take the points, the difference in points away from your skill level until you reach zero. Zero, and if you have to take more away than you have, then you fail in the test. It's a typical German system. It's heavy loaded, sluggish and hard to learn, but if you get into it, it works. Luckily, everything is automated in this game, so we don't have to roll. We only see what's coming out at the end. So the most important part is courage, cleverness, intuition, charisma, dexterity. Dexterity can be at 10. Agility 10 at least. Constitution should be 10 and strength 10. So we have 4 more points to give away. What do we need for our Skeletarius? Courage, charisma. Fastness of body is practically a magical body armor you can put on. I will come to it later. Ignifaxus Burst of Flame is practically a... What is it? A stream of fire. Lance of Fire and Light, yeah. So, it needs... Constitution, yeah. Very low attribute by us, so nice. Yeah, I see. We have to go a little bit more into constitution and agility. Do we need such high charisma? Yeah, to a degree, wouldn't be so bad. I mean, we have some social talents we could. Yeah, and I want to have a more social character at the end. Two as mage and social character. So we have vitality. This is practically, if this say are going to zero, we are down, we are dead. You can die in this game, but not forever, but only for a fight, or you reload. Astral energy is the amount of the magic points, practically. Certain magic points, and if we cast Skeletarius, it takes away 8, so we have only 31 left. And in the tabletops, they regenerate very slowly, but in this game, they regenerate very fast, so that's okay. Endurance is for some special combat abilities like Mighty Blow, who needs has some costs at 20 points, yeah. Then resistance to magic is okay. If you want somebody want to control you, his role is so his talent, sehr, or the skill level gets lowered by 6. Then dodge, how good you can dodge arrows and bolt rounds. How good an attack is, how good you can hit somebody and parry, how good you can defend against. We select in combat how this goes. Yeah, range combat, if we would have a ranged weapon, which we do not have. And hit points, they have 1d6 minus 4 damage with our fists. So, practically nothing. So, arcane knowledge, because we are a mage. We don't treat wounds, we are a mage. We need no plans, because I want to go on alchemy. So we can create our own healing potions and so on. So then we go to the spells. Skeletarius on max level. A little bit of Ignifoxus wouldn't hurt. And fastness of body. 1 plus level 3 is maximum. So the maximum what's possible is for us practically 2. So we have a 0 modifier and a 1 modifier. So okay. Yeah. Then we point it out to 5. Up to 5. 2, maybe 3. 3 here. 2. To calm animals is always good. If we can do it. If we're gonna fight, we fight with sabers offensively at best. You can have 5 points more in attack or in parade than the other, but not more. So the next points, number 6, would have to go into parry. Perception is good to that we see something. Yeah. But willpower is more important, because with willpower we attack, we can sustain more wounds before we not more wounds, but we can not suffer wounds from damage, and that's important, because if you suffer 5 wounds you die 2, even if you are at full health. So we have 14 points left. Go into the bony and penalties. We need penalties to get more points. So social, I do not want disadvantages. So physical disadvantages, perception, physical talents, all around, sneak. Do we need sneak? Nah. Sneaking is for faction, so the god for thieves and merchants. And we are a honorable Nawadi, we don't sneak, we charge, or let charge. So artisan, what can it be? Artisan talent penalty. Oh yeah, that's not what I wanted. Combat penalties. Yeah, would be the best to say, okay, we daggers we don't use. And we do not use at least throwing weapons. If we use staves later on, I don't know, but maybe. But this bonus and penalty system is only for the game here. It's more complicated in the tabletop game. So we increase willpower, yes. A little bit of talking would be good. How far high? 5 is the max. 9 points left. Okay. We do not have to spend it all. Do you want to spend it in savers? Or to say I don't care about how good I can fight? Yeah, okay. So we see what weapon we go with later on, except daggers and throwing weapons. Yeah. So. Fast talk. Intimidate is good. Plants and perception. Can we lower? Ah. Okay. Perception 3 should be okay. 3 in plant lore. You see it can get expensive very fast. Yeah, okay, 2 points in bows. I don't know. Do we want to fight anyway? I mean, we shouldn't, but 4, yeah, in our Ignifaxis would be good. The Corpofrigo Cold Shock is lowering the stats of the enemy, so it's a debuff. Light in the darkness is practically a tiny light which is flying over me. Yeah, seems good. Don't need the buffs for me. We have a fighting staff, nice. And a Kefjev, whatever. The Kefjev is one in the land of first sunlight, the desert. While a Kefjev protects its wearer from harsh sunlight and wind, it has no defensive value in combat. Yeah, only 1 point of damage reduction. Oh, and dwarves cannot wear this. Yeah, okay, understood. 1 point into astral energy and 1 point into vitality, and then we have 2 points left. I guess we can. Yeah. We can. Be 2 points, so we take these 2 points into the game. So, accept changes and immediately start adventure. So, now we're going in, but since we will see more gameplay next turn. So, Zeus and with many Stukas.